video review is a compilation of our efforts reviewing more than 20 mixer grinder models in the past years. And this isn't based on just comparing specifications, but based on hands-on review, testing and evaluating the dry grinding and wet grinding performances, noise levels, RPM, ease of cleaning, and many more aspects. While at it, we'll be busting a few common misconceptions about how power affects the performance and the noise levels of the mixer grinder. If you want to skip the buying guide that discusses what to look for when buying a mixer grinder and dive right into our top recommendations, then you can skip to the timestamp mentioned here. Else, let's get started. So power is supposed to be an important aspect to consider when buying a mixer grinder. We have always recommended that ideally your mixer grinder should have at least 750 watt power. But models from Panasonic and Attenberg have challenged that notion. These mixer grinders can grind even tough ingredients like turmeric without much of any problem. On the other hand, options like Crompton MU and Prestige Iris Plus struggle with these even though they have a 750 watt motor. So overall, it is the product quality, the quality of the raw materials used, and the jar design that plays a more important role than just the wattage. Let's talk a little bit more about the jar design. Ideally, your chutney jar should have blades that almost touch the bottom. This way, it can grind even smaller quantities of ingredients easily. Chutney jars of Sujata, Preeti, and Philips have this kind of design. If this is not the case, when grinding ginger, garlic paste, onion, or such ingredients, they will stay trapped in the gap between the blade and the bottom without getting blended into a fine paste. Next, the wet grinding jar should have a conical design and not a wide base. This way, the rotating blades will be able to create a strong vortex that can blend more efficiently. Coming to the safety aspects, vacuum suction feet and overload protection switch are standard features you can find in almost all mixer grinders. Another feature that is good to have is lid locks. Options like Panasonic and Hamilton Beach go one step further, and you won't be able to run these mixer grinders unless you lock the lid properly to the jar and the jar properly to the base. Noise is also an important consideration for most people, and contrary to what most people think, lower wattage doesn't necessarily mean lower noise. For example, the Panasonic mixer grinder with 600 watts motor and Usha juicer mixer grinder with 450 watt motor produces noise levels of around 85 to 90 decibels, similar to many 750 watt models. It is true that higher wattage models like Bosch TrueMix with 1000 watt motor and Hamilton mixer grinder with 1400 watt motor generate more noise, typically around 95 to 100 decibels of noise. But on the other side, Sujata Dynamix with its 900 watt motor produces only around 90 decibels of noise, comparable to lower wattage models. These examples show that wattage and noise doesn't necessarily correlate directly. So now that we have covered the basic aspects to consider when buying a mixer grinder, let's take a look at our top recommendations of best mixer grinder with food processor, best budget-friendly options, and best in terms of safety. Our recommendation of the overall best mixer grinder is the Sujata Dynamix with 900 watt motor and 3 jars. Even after testing all these mixer grinders, it is Sujata that I personally use in my kitchen. It can grind almost all types of ingredients with ease. Be it tough ingredients like turmeric, idli dosha batter, or even small quantities of ginger garlic paste. The noise level is also moderate at around 85 to 90 decibels. Yet another advantage is that Sujata Dynamix can be used for 90 minutes at a stretch with 5 minutes break after every 3 minutes of running. This makes it an apt choice for large families and even home chefs. Most other models offer just 30 minutes of runtime. Coming to the drawbacks, it doesn't have an overload protection switch. The build quality of the jars and blades are quite good, but sometimes the handle may break after a few years of use. Also, the paint of the aluminum jar lock may peel off after a while, which can be a bit unpleasant to look at. Most people ask how Sujata Dynamix fare with Bosch TrueMix Pro. The advantage of Bosch TrueMix is that it has lid locks, which makes it safer and hands-free. It looks aesthetically better too, but otherwise, in terms of grinding performance, noise, and ease of cleaning, Sujata fares a lot better than Bosch TrueMix Pro. Now, if you're looking for a food processor with the mixer grinder, then Preeti Zodiac is one of the best options that we can recommend. It has a 750 watt motor and 5 jars. See, most food processors like Usha FP3811 and Inalsa try to do everything and get none of them right. For example, the French fries cutter, centrifugal juicer attachment and whisk are pathetic. Preeti Zodiac, on the other hand, has just the right attachments. A slicer, grater, chopping and kneading blades, and citrus juicer. And they all work quite well. Above all, the mixer grinder jars are pretty good at grinding. And the spare part availability and after-sales service is quite good. Something that many other brands fail at. That being said, Preeti Zodiac's juicer jar, in spite of its innovative design, isn't the best. In fact, juicer jars of almost all mixer grinders leave behind a lot of juice in the pulp, making it a waste. Now, if you don't want a juicer jar, you could opt for Preeti Scion, which costs around 2,800 rupees lesser. Now, let's take a look at the budget-friendly option. Our first recommendation is the Philips HL7756, which comes with a 750 watt motor and 3 jars. It is well designed and can grind dry and wet ingredients with equal ease. You can even grind garam masala occasionally without much trouble. Other chores like dosa batter, chutney, masala can all be done easily. However, avoid turmeric as it could be a bit too much for the motor and the jars. Its drawbacks are that the jars are thin. The plastic lid of the multi-purpose jar tends to become loose after a while. Also, you have to take care not to leave the jars wet for a long time, else rust can develop underneath the blade as the steel used is not 304 grade. Yet another option that we recommend is the Butterfly Jet Elite with 750 watt motors and 4 jars including a juicer jar. Its grinding performance too is better than many other options available at this price range. You can grind idli batter, chutney, masala, etc. fairly easily. But like several other options, it is not the best for grinding small quantities of ingredients. Also, avoid running it for long duration as it can affect its durability. Now, if safety is your priority yet you don't want to compromise too much on the performance, then Panasonic would be an ideal option to consider thanks to its double lock mechanism. So, unless you lock the lid properly and the jar properly to the base, it won't start working. It is also good at grinding all types of ingredients including turmeric, garam masala, idli batter, chutney and so on. But its chutney jar is not the best for grinding smaller quantities. You can check out the link to the detailed review of each of these mixer grinders that we have mentioned in the description. The purchase links are also mentioned there. Thanks for watching.